You're right, you're right, you're right, you're right. People love to be right.
How many of you want to sell more products? How do you grow a business? Top line, move the top line, sell businesses.
I don't want to waste more than 5 minutes on $3,000.
The question is, what if I want to monetize my content ideas?
It's going to be a great product and a great service. You don't need to go prove it. Power players, all of you out there, I got something exciting for you today. You know who I am, Grant Cardone. This cat right here, though, is my cousin. That's right. As soon as I met him, I'm like, bro, we have to be somewhere. You and I need, we must be genetically, I'm telling you, I think your mom or my mom or your dad or something, somewhere, grandparents, somewhere they hooked up on a boat somewhere on an island somewhere long ago. Ivan Tapia, you call him Ivan, okay? I call him Ivan, but everybody knows him as a power player. He is one of the top network marketers in the world today, okay? Huge earner. I don't even know if I can report your earnings. Can I hear?
Yeah, you can. You're good.
10 a year.
Yeah, this year's going to be around 10.
Dude, that's big, dude. That is like when somebody tells me they can freaking pull that down, that tells me work ethic, push through a bunch. You weren't raised with money, right?
Oh no, hell no.
Tell me, how'd you
about Oh, we come from middle class. I'm come from Tijuana, Mexico. So.
Tijuana, is there a middle class in Tijuana?
You know, there's middle class and then there's another middle class in that middle class, you know?
So yeah, there's low class.
No, I come from middle class. My mom used to work in this hospital called IMS, basically, and as a nurse, and my father as in the pharmaceutical department on the same hospital. It's a public hospital. My mom used to be making $600, $500 maybe a month. My dad used to be making probably similar amounts per month.
And so your parents were making $12,000 a year?
Yeah, around there.
Dude, that's crazy.
Yeah, around there. And they were very hardworking. Uh-huh. You know? They always try to give me the best.
Yeah. How many kids?
Well, I'm the last one. Uh-huh. My dad was married once. And he had seven half sisters and one half brother from my dad. And then my mom, this is their last marriage. So I'm the only child from this marriage.
Oh, I got it. So how many siblings in total though?
I'll be seven sisters and two brothers.
Wow. Okay. And then me.
And then you.
And then your cousin GC.
Grant Cardone Tapia right here.
Yeah, that's right. Grant Cardone Tapia. Okay. You can call me, Grant. So look, that means their parents, you know, whether it was two parents or four parents or whatever, like, were taking care of nine kids.
Yeah. Well, not really. Because they were my brother and all my siblings are eight years older than me. So there's only actually one sibling living with me when I was growing up.
But somewhere your dad or your mom's side or whatever, like, they were having to fund those other kids though.
Yeah, they were.
Feed them, take care of them, school them.
Oh, yeah.
So hats off to your parents for.
Oh, big time. Yeah. Big time. I mean.
So who had the biggest influence on you, Yvonne? Was it your mom or your dad?
I think at the beginning it was my mom, reality. I mean, my mom, she's one of the most hardest working ladies I've seen in my life. Uh-huh. And then, but she had a neuro disease. It's like kind of like those weird things, nervous system.
Oh,
so
wow.
She cannot walk very well right now. She's like 60 something, but she cannot walk. And she couldn't walk, started walking like that since like 30 something.
Wow.
So she got retired early from the hospital because she couldn't work anymore. That's how it happened.
Uh-huh.
And when she got retired and pension, there was not enough money. And she started doing some other stuff. She actually started network marketing when I was like 13 years of age.
Wow.
And she was trying to bring me to the meetings.
Uh-huh.
And I used to hate it. I used to hate him, honestly.
You were 13.
I was 13. Yeah, and yeah. They're taking me to 100 people meeting, old people meeting. And that's in my mind, right?
Right, right, right.
And then what happened is, she was there for like 10 years, but it was very good because it brought me to an environment where I saw successful people. I met one of the top leaders. I remember I met a guy that we really admire in network marketing, which is Jim Rohn.
And
So he was like the ambassador of that company.
Uh-huh.
Okay, so that was Herbalife. So that happened for like 10 years, and she always wanted to bring me. When I met my wife, I remember she was trying to get me and my wife also. To go and do that company. I was like, no, mom, I'm going to be a civil engineer.
Uh-huh.
My dream was always to come to the U.S., you know. I'm going to go to the U.S., I'm going to study over there. I used to play baseball, so I used to say, you know, I'm going to be a professional baseball player. I used to pitch very good. And when I came over here, I always said, no, engineering is my thing.
You went to school here?
Yes. Yeah,
so where?
San Diego State University. Okay. We graduated there. Prior to there, we went to Cal State, California State of LA.
So, and who paid for your college?
We took a little loan out. Well, uh-huh. I took a loan out.
Uh-huh.
And my mom and my dad helped with half of it on college, on the first 2 years. And the last 3 years or whatever, it was the loan.
So you borrowed money from the government.
I got money from the government.
Yeah.
I had to.
Yeah. Have you paid them back?
I did.
Okay, good.
I paid them back.
I need to know that you did that.
So. I paid them back. Reality is, I couldn't pay them back for 2 years. It got really bad at one point. When we graduated from civil engineering, I was all fired up because now I'm saying I got a job.
Yeah.
I'm making my first job. I remember it was between getting a $70,000 per job per year and a $50,000. But the guy from $50,000, my former bosses. They sold me the idea that small company of three engineers was going to become a monster company.
Mm-hmm.
Well, that's 2008 when the recession hit hard.
Oh, wow.
I was the first one without a job. Uh-huh. We just bought a home.
So they got rid of you?
They got rid of me.
Yeah, yeah.
They told me about
the other company would probably got rid of you too.
I don't know. It was a big, big company.
Uh-huh.
So I don't know.
Yeah.
But everything happens for a reason, right?
Uh-huh.
And what happened there is, we bought a home in Tijuana, Mexico. It was a nice big home, but we lost it. When we lost our job, we lost the home. I remember I used to have a car, a Grand Cherokee. My wife had a Toyota RAV4, and we had to sell one of my car. We kept with my wife. I had to go to the San Diego Credit Union and ask them for, you know, a 2 year so I can pay in 2 years, and then I got the loan. I couldn't pay it. It was only $150 per
and
month.
This is only 9 years ago.
That was 9 years ago.
Yeah, I
couldn't pay it, and they were calling me every month. I'm sorry, guys. I got no job. I cannot pay this. And basically, what happened there? Somebody invited me to another network marketing meeting, and the guy who invited me is I was actually working as a civil engineer, and it was the designer on the top floor.
Wow.
He one day he got in a brand new Nissan Armada, and now I saw him in. I'm like, oh, he changed cars because he used to have a Toyota Ranger, like mm-hmm. 5 years older. So he comes in, I was like, hey man, congrats, you got a new car. And he's like, oh yeah, I got it with my new business. I'm like, what new business? What are you talking mm-hmm. about? You're here. What are you talking about? And then he takes this juice out and puts it there, and my table says, yeah, I'm talking to your bosses about a meeting. I'm like, that looks, you guys are drinking. You guys yeah. drinking wine or what's going on? It's like, it's Friday, invite me. He's like, yeah, you can come over. So I sat down and he starts talking network marketing. When he starts talking network marketing, I could see my boss is kind of like, oh my God, network marketing.
I can't believe I agreed to this.
Exactly. Yeah. And I'm looking at him, I'm like, he just bought the Nissan Armada from this juice. I'm listening, like, right. I'm excited. And it's like, how much are you making, man? He's like, oh, like 15K. I'm like, 15K? Mm-hmm. And you're still working. So he's like, yeah. I was like, okay, that sounds interesting. And I remember my wife and myself, like, we'll buy it to try it out. We're not really interested. A month later, we got laid off, right? Mm-hmm. So he calls me up. We're going to go to this meeting. It's like, all right, what is it about? He's like, don't worry about it. There's a lot of money. And yeah, I'm like, is that the juice thing? Yeah. Maybe it is, maybe it isn't, you know? I'm like, that's fine. We'll try it out and see. So my friend Steven, we go to this DoubleTree Hilton in San Diego, Mission Valley. We go there. It's like 600 people. And then this guy comes in. They're edifying him like crazy. I'm 25 back then. He was 27. And he comes in.
You're out of work.
I'm out of work.
You can't pay your bills.
I can't pay my bills.
You're late on the student loan. Can't make a $100 payment.
Yeah.
So you're like,
yeah. So we come in and he's in there and he comes really sharp. I didn't know what Louis Vuitton was. I didn't know what any of those brands. I knew nothing.
Look at this guy. This guy's got flowers on his pants.
Okay. But I didn't know nothing. Uh-huh. So for because
he's got look at his t-shirt's 200. Maybe more.
but the reality is in Mexico, you normally see like Dolce & Gabbana. You maybe see that without an L.
Yeah. You bought it on the street corner.
Yeah. So I'm looking and I'm like, oh, that looks nice. I have no idea. But we get out and he has a Mercedes S63 AMG.
Yeah.
When I see the car, I remember his name is Calvin and we got a really good friendship, me and Calvin. And I'm like, bro, how you bought that car? It's like one payment. Now you're blowing up my mind because
right.
I thought rich people were come from wealthy families,
yeah.
you know, celebrities or sports celebrities.
Uh-huh.
That's what I used to think.
Yeah.
Now he's showing me that. I'm like, network marketing? I'm like, that juice thing? And he was making 120K per month. He showed me.
Yeah. See, he's still humble because just so you guys know, he's making 8 times that today. Okay. The guy that impressed him was making $120. And he's making almost that 10 times every month.
Yeah.
Only 8 years.
Yeah.
So how did you get over like the things that everybody else talks about network marketing being, oh, it's a pyramid and it's this and you know, nobody ever makes it. How did you work through that? Or were you just so hungry at the time to take care of your family?
Well, that's a great question. Reality is that I give always the benefit of the doubt to the people until they show me it's wrong, you know?
Uh-huh.
And when he showed me the car, I'm like, I need to go to your home to see this is more real,
yeah,
you know?
Yeah, more than a car.
Yeah. And he's like, sure, next week. And I'm like, all right, Steven, we need to go. It's like, okay. So we went there. And now he not only has the Mercedes, he has a white BMW. I'm never going to forget because he was in a suit. He's like, I got to get ready for a meeting. I'm like, okay. Like 50 people go to his home and he comes with shorts, pair of shorts. I'm like, the hell, he got ready, he dressed up. So he's so humble also.
Uh-huh.
And he gets us all a big welcome. And now in my mind, I'm like, hold on, this guy has results.
Yeah.
And whoever can tell me this isn't real, I already saw it.
Yeah, yeah.
So now I get home and I keep family, friends, and everybody's telling me, you're crazy, bro. You're a civil engineer,
mm-hmm.
get a job. You know, you're a Latino in the U.S. You should at least go back because I used to work at GNC, Home Depot, La Jolla Vision Tennis Club, all those places. You should go back there. And I'm like, no, man, I'm a civil engineer even there. I go a civil engineer, get a job, a civil engineer, because I was looking every day for a civil engineering job to be okay. And I heard a phrase from Jim Rohn. That's one of the first points. He said, work full-time on your job, part-time on your fortune. So I was looking for a full-time job.
Can you repeat that again?
Yeah. Work full-time on your job, part-time on your fortune.
Uh-huh.
So what happened...
Until you can work full-time on your fortune.
Exactly. Yeah. Exactly. He always talk about creating an electrifying story part-time until it becomes an electrifying story full-time.
Uh-huh.
And I was so fired up on that. And it took me basically almost 2 years to find a full-time job. It got really bad because... We lost our home. We had to. We
went 2008, back. 9, and 10. Then you're just looking for work.
Now I'm in unemployment, right? I'm in unemployment, and unemployment. I was getting, I don't know, like $800 or whatever, you know. And now we are in a smaller home. It rained very bad, and it got full of, like, I don't know. In Spanish, mold. It's called mold.
Mold.
So yeah. It got mold, yeah. and our clothes mold. It was bad. Like, yeah. My wife, she was pregnant, 8 months. We were sleeping on a couch. It was bad. And I remember family members, friends used to tell my wife, why are you still with him?
Like, what, like a loser.
Like, yeah, he's a loser.
Ivan Tapia, the loser.
So we went back living with my parents, and it was that bad.
Dude, that had to kill you, huh?
Oh, it was bad. Every night, my wife is like, we need to get out of here. We need to get out of here. And I was looking for a job, and network marketing was not doing it. Mm-hmm. I remember I was very bad at public speaking.
Had you joined with Steven at this point?
Yeah, I'm joined.
Oh, so you're in it.
So I'm in it.
You're still looking for a job.
I'm still looking for a job. I paid
$1,500. I didn't get that. Okay. Uh-huh.
So I didn't say that, but so I paid $1,500 to get in. Into network marketing. I come into the house with over 50 plus, now to my parents' house, 50 plus
boxes of
juice. My parents think that I lost it, you know? And my mom, she used to do network marketing, but she's like, you never join with me. Now you're doing this.
Right, right.
I'm not joining with you, kind of thing.
Oh, wow, that's interesting.
And I tell my brother, and my brother's like, he's eight years older than me. He's like, nah, man, you take it. My wife, she's drinking the juice, but she's like, okay, I want you to still get a job, you know?
Yeah, of course.
And my dad's really disappointed. He's like looking at me like, man, you messed up. Like, you really messed up.
Yeah.
And what happened, I didn't care because I used to see Calvin, I used to see Steven. I'm like, man, I don't care. I'm going to get their results. I don't care. And I remember I started calling in friends. Everybody said, you're nuts. Mm-hmm. So I said, my friends are joining. I need to start contacting new people. Mm-hmm. And back in the day, social media wasn't that big. So, not even in Mexico. So now in Tijuana, you see me as a civil engineer, graduate in the U.S., giving out flyers on the streets because I didn't have money to pay for anybody.
Wow.
I was on the streets. I even went to my old high school to give out flyers when the kids were coming out of school. Some old friends' moms saw me. It's like, Ivan, what are you doing here? Oh, and I got really nervous because they're like, I thought you graduated from San Diego State. Mm-hmm. I opened my business. Like, what's your business? It feels horrible.
So,
check it out. The office is here. But so it was really bad. I remember our best month, it was $800 in those first 2 years in network marketing.
Wow. And you spent $1,500. So you're negative seven, no money coming in.
No, hold on. It was $1,500 once.
Yeah.
But there's an auditship. So $150 every month.
Oh, wow.
You go to events. Uh-huh. You pay events. You pay tickets. Uh-huh. You pay all of that stuff. And I remember my debt now is over $70,000 because of the loan. We lost the home.
Right.
The car. My debt is over $70,000 now. Uh-huh. And I remember I was bad, but my Steven said, let's go to another event. I was like, all right, another event. Let's go. And I remember I was in the back seat, in the background. I was like, man, I don't see it.
Yeah.
And then this guy gets on the stage. He's actually from Florida, Steve Merritt. And he gets on the stage with his wife. And they get a briefcase of over $1 million. This is like 2010. And they're talking. Is this
in Tijuana?
No, this is in San Diego. Okay. No, sorry. Anaheim, California.
Okay.
And they're throwing the bills up. And they're saying, what recession? What recession? And wow. I'm like, I'm in depression now.
Recession. Yeah.
And then this guy comes on stage and he says, if you guys want to get this, you need to buy the $1,500 package one more time because you didn't do it right the first time.
Uh-huh.
Now I'm there, and again, I give the benefit of the doubt. I tell my wife, we're buying those $1,500. And she's like, no.
Dude.
And I come
home. By the way, this would be back. Somebody would throw in his face right now. Insanity is repeating the same behavior, expecting a different result. So I know we've all been told that. He's about to move on the insane thing. He's going to do it again. And I think it's important for everybody to understand is like persistence at some point requires some level of either insanity or desperation or what was it for you, you think?
Desperation, uh-huh. Definitely. Uh-huh. It was desperation, but I also combined a little bit of pleasure because I always had in my mind the cars and the house of Calvin. And I always saw him. I'm like, okay, I'm desperate, but that's going to be us. That's mm-hmm. going to be us, mm-hmm. you know?
So you held that aspiration.
Oh, yeah, all the time, uh-huh. all the time. I remember.
But dude, what do you think, because in 2010, there aren't a few people out of work. There's hundreds of millions of people out of work. There's probably 50 or 60 million people losing their homes in the United States of America. Mm-hmm. I don't even know what's going on in Tijuana. It had to be terrible.
It was bad. It was bad.
So why you? Why are all those people, cousins, uncles, aunts, brothers that you have, would not even look at network marketing at the lowest period of their life, but you're like, hey, this is going to be my vehicle?
I think in network marketing, people need to believe in the person who they're actually like selling the opportunity, you know, or associating with. Uh-huh. And I don't think when people saw me, my friends, they trusted me, but they didn't believe, they didn't respect me at the business level. Uh-huh. And yeah. I think that's what happened. It's reality.
Because they were so close to you, they knew about you went to college, didn't have a job.
Yeah, I was living with my parents.
Yeah, yeah.
You know, and lost it all.
Hard for them to like put trust in what like, didn't look like success yeah. yet.
They saw me as like, he's desperate. I used to tell them, go to the meeting. Yeah. They never show up to the meeting.
Yeah, yeah. Because you didn't have altitude with them.
Exactly.
You were down. Yeah.
Exactly.
So you couldn't.
And I was the youngest one.
Uh-huh. Yeah, 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 yeah.
So they saw me, I was like.
So dude, where was the breakthrough? What was the breakthrough? Was it the second package?
Well, not really. Uh-huh.
God, it gets worse.
Oh, it gets
You're
worse.
Killing me here, man. I'm getting depressed. I'm like, when do we quit? I want to quit. I'm ready to quit. This is IML? Is this?
This is another company.
Okay.
So what happened there, that company, we're out of money. And
You were out of money or they were?
I'm out of money. Uh-huh. I'm out of money. And so my sponsor quits. Uh-huh. My sponsor, who was making like 15K, he once calls me and I'm like, bro, what's up? He's like, it's going down, man. Like my check's to like 2K. Uh-huh. But I saw him like parting out like the 15K. But meanwhile, I always saw Calvin always working big time. Uh-huh. And I was like, that's the difference. He never stopped.
And Calvin rested. The other dude.
Yeah, and Steven rested.
Yeah, Steven rested.
And I was like, wow, that's the difference.
Yeah,
so,
yeah.
But I didn't know you can keep going when your sponsor quits. So what happened there? I started another network marketing. So somebody else invited me, but 4 months later, the company shut down. So now I quit the company.
And let me just say this, okay, for all of you out there, it's like, oh yeah, that's what happens with network marketing.
Yeah.
Okay, look, some of the biggest companies on this planet shut down. The average company in America today, only last 8 years.
Yeah.
So I hear a lot of people in network marketing, that company shut down. Yeah, so what? I mean, companies shut down. Pan American Airlines shut down, right? Like a lot of companies shut down, great companies. It doesn't mean.
Yeah. For me, it wasn't.
You didn't shut down.
I didn't care because I didn't shut down.
You transitioned.
It's like people don't shut down, right?
You
can't shut down. So so my company let me go as an engineer. So I always had that in my mind. I was like, people, you go back to engineering. I'm like, they let me go when I was 25.
Yeah.
That tells you that maybe when I'm 35 or 45, it will happen again, recession.
Sure.
So I don't want to be older now and not take advantage of it. Uh-huh. So for me, it was like an alarm, you know, like, thank God it happened to me when I was 25.
Yeah, yeah,
that's
yeah,
what
yeah.
I think. So besides that, now the company shut down and then somebody, my breakthrough actually happened in the prior company to IML. In this company, now I got a job. Now I'm working as a civil engineer for San Diego Airport.
And you did that just to be the filler. You were being responsible, really.
I had to, right?
Yeah, yeah,
I
was, yeah. That, until you built your business, you had to pay your bills.
Exactly. And it was $72,000 per year I was making. It was, uh-huh. So that was like, oh, we can breathe now.
A little relief.
After we got the job, we left to another apartment. 6 months later, we're living in Chula Vista, back in San Diego again. Mm-hmm. And we're living there. And basically, when you're in the construction, you're working 60 hours a week minimum. Mm-hmm. I was working for Kiewit Construction, and it was a big company. And that company now is getting me in at construction 6 a.m., getting off work minimum 5:30, 6 p.m., sometimes later, 8 p.m. or whatever. That's why even it was a more sense of urgency for myself to say, hey, man, You got to go out there now and do network marketing now more with more energy. Uh-huh. That's reality. And
to get out of this thing, this 60-hour thing.
Yes.
You have a baby coming now, or you already?
Oh, she was born already. Yeah,
yeah. 2 years old, probably. Now, right?
She was a year actually. Year,
okay.
And basically, what happened is, we joined that opportunity, but now I have a little bit of money. I'm still 70K in debt because I'm just paying the monthlies, right?
Right. Right.
And I always said I'm gonna do the network marketing. I'm gonna pay all the debts, as I always believe. And what happened is basically that we joined this opportunity. So my breakthrough, this is where my breakthrough comes. The company I was 7 months in, still not, it's almost 3 years, and I haven't made $1,000 in our marketing per month yet.
Wow.
And we went to this meeting, and it was 1,500 people. I was very mad in that meeting because I thought I was going to get paid by my sponsor to go to that meeting. I get nothing, so I took five people. I paid everything for them from Tijuana. And we're sitting there, this event is in Pasadena, so we drove from Tijuana, all these people. So we're in Pasadena, California, and this guy comes to the stage, and his name is Holton. And Holton, he was earning over $1 million a month.
Wow.
Now, when he comes on stage, I'm like, all right, now this is a whole different ballgame now.
Yeah.
Now, my mind is
15 grand to 100 grand to now.
Now, my mind is expanding right now. I'm going like crazy up here. And he talks about Napoleon Hill, Think and Grow Rich, and I'm taking notes like crazy. I'm like, I need to get closer to this guy. And next day, I'm talking to my sponsor, and that was my breakthrough. After that event, 2 months later, I was earning 1,000. 2 months later, 3,000. 2 months later, 6,000. 3 months later, 23,000. And then 3 months later, we were at 50,000. And then 11 months later, with 120,000, and our best month in that company was 170,000.
Wow.
That was before IML.
Stay with us on Power Players, okay? Give us a few minutes. We're going to be right back with you. This is Ivan Tapia. He just took you from a story where I was like, I'm ready to quit. Dude, don't quit, guys. Don't quit, man.
Don't quit until
you're in that chair in any business.
Never.
Sales call with the girl, with the guy, with your parents.
That's true.
Don't quit. Don't quit if there's an upside greater than a downside. Okay, we'll be right back.
You're right. You're right. You're right. You're right. People love to be right.
How many of you want to sell more products? How do you grow a business? Top line. Move the top line. Sell businesses.
I don't want to waste more than 5 minutes on $3,000.
The question is, what if I want to monetize my content ideas?
It's going to be a great product and a great service. You don't need to go prove it.
Okay, so welcome back to Power Players. Grant Cardone here. I'm with my friend, my cousin, my brother from another mother.
Primo.
Ivan Tapia. Tapia or Tapia?
Tapia, you got
Tapia,
it.
Tapia, Tapia.
Like Bad Boys, Johnny Tapia, remember?
Oh yeah. He was a criminal, right?
Yeah.
That ain't you though. This is a good dude right here. Okay, wait till you meet his wife. This guy's a closer.
Amazing. I close deals.
He closed deal, okay? This guy is a $10 million a year producer. He has come from nothing. This is an example of somebody that deserves to sit in the chair that is to my left, and I hope one day you sit in that chair because you did something. He didn't think about it. He didn't read about it. He did it. He's also an investor with me at Cardone Capital, okay? He's invested a lot of money. He believes in me. He told me in my office, dude, I just believe in you. So he's spending most of his time working on his business, and then takes his money and says, hey, I want to grow this wealth.
Totally.
Okay, and those are different activities, right?
Oh, yeah, a lot of different activities.
So when you started, when you transitioned, tell me about what it was like when you went from making, you didn't make $1,000 a month. No. To all of a sudden now you're making 10,000 or...
Yeah, right there I was making 120K average.
A year?
Yeah.
Yeah. So you now you finally started to make more money than you did as a civil engineer. When did you drop that job?
I remember the date exactly, July 13, 2012.
Okay, Friday, so 5 13th. Years ago. Yeah. Oh yeah, okay. You're not superstitious? I would think that you're superstitious.
I thought it was perfect.
You did, huh?
I thought it was perfect.
That's awesome. So in 5 years, you dropped a job. That had to be, your dad was he freaking?
No, now he's happy because now he's seeing that when we dropped the job, we're making 23K. So I showed him the check, and his phrase was just like, I hope it lasts.
Of course. They're parents. Yeah. Dude, your parents are always going to have, they're going to be cautious.
Yeah.
No matter what. Now, they're parents. It's his job to be cautious, right?
Totally.
So what happened? What's different now? What are you doing different, Yvonne, that's making the business successful?
Well, reality is it's a lot of experience, a lot of that we know, the know-how, how to do the business. When we got introduced to our new opportunity, which is International Markets Live, IML, that was like almost 2 years ago. Next month's going to be 2 years. And what happened is our check of 120K had actually dropped to maybe 60K a month. Which is it's still great. Yeah, I know. It's
yeah,
but it was still good money.
Yeah,
but what happened?
You knew something was changing.
Something was changing. Yeah. But the major thing for me is that I needed to feel that I could bring a new person and I can actually help them.
Right.
And I stopped believing that.
Uh-huh.
And when I saw the opportunity that we have now, I truly saw an opportunity where we can bring a brand new customer, a brand new person, and help them with our services, not only network marketing. So what has happened in reality, we got customers right now that don't even know network marketing, and they're actually making more money than the actual distributor that actually invited them or the leader that invited them.
Wow.
So that's amazing.
So what is IML?
IML is a network marketing company that we basically provide educational platform on trading, Forex, and cryptocurrency market. That's what we do. And a
lot of interest in that.
Oh, yeah.
Okay. I tell people, man, leave the crypto thing alone. Everybody's like, but tell me how to do it. Okay, they just tell me how to do it. So there's interest. Where there's interest, you guys, somebody needs to serve that interest.
Totally.
Because it's not like crypto's going to go away.
It's for sure staying. It's an amazing market, and a lot of people want to know about it. But the thing is, there's lack of information. There's a lot of people that don't know about it. And because they don't know, they go like through network marketing. They go through the wrong people, and they lose their money. Mm-hmm. Our job is to basically train and educate people so they can make the right decision on the investing part of it. Mm-hmm. So on the Forex and crypto. So when they do that, we can teach them, they can become customers.
Yeah, so explain to everybody what Forex is.
Okay, it's a Forex exchange market. So basically we're in the US, we use US dollars. You gotta go to Mexico, you gotta use Mexican peso. So you got a currency exchange and you change your dollars for pesos. You go to Europe, you're gonna change your dollars for euros. And basically, whatever the exchange rate is, that's what happens. What happens with the Forex now, we got brokers. So brokers, actually, they give a very much better fee than an exchange business. So,
and the money's made in the exchange of dollars to euros,
exactly,
or euros to pesos.
Exactly. So there's money made there. So because of the, there's called and fundamental analysis, which is basically the news. The news comes, Trump says something, or Mexican president says something, or whatever company says something.
Yeah.
The currency goes up or down.
And somebody wants to sell or somebody wants to buy.
That's basically what happens.
And anytime money, anytime money changes hands, or money goes to crypto, or crypto becomes a peso, money's going to be made, period.
Exactly,
right?
Period. That's basically what it is, exactly. So we educate people on when to buy or when to sell, Basically, that's what it is.
And I read a book. I'm sorry to interrupt you, but I read a book. Most powerful book I ever read about money was when I was like 14 or 15 years old. And he says, the book said, I don't remember the name. I think it was OPM.
Okay.
He says, look, there's only so many ways to make money in this book. He's like, the closer you get to not having a product where it's just money for money, that's banks. That's what banks do. That's what, so the closer you get, that's why Goldman Sachs is Goldman Sachs, right? Because they're placing money.
That's great.
With no product.
That's great. Yeah. Well, that's similar to what we do in reality. I mean, we actually teach people, so they come in with a $218 package, which is not the $1,500 we used to come with, which is normal marketing. And they come in and they get educated. For me, it's like, I teach them, instead of going, it's like going to school. And you're paying a monthly fee to get educated. And we got over 80 plus educators. So they're getting educated live by them in the live market. Mm-hmm. And then we got a pre-recorded academy.
Live market meaning they're actually watching the market as it trades currencies.
Exactly.
And they're showing them, no, you wouldn't want to do it here, you'd want to do it there. And that costs somebody $218 a month.
Exactly.
You know, I think I'll join right now just to learn how to do the deal. I'm scared though. If I only pay $162, I won't.
And that's one of the major probably challenges that people see the business of what they pay. So they see $162. They don't see how this is a $1 million business for them. Yeah, you know. Yeah. For me in my mind, this is a huge business. So.
But dude, I know people that go to Princeton, pay $200,000 a year, and don't pay attention.
Exactly.
So I'm like.
So we got this business right now. We went from when we joined, we was 1,200 customers only. The company was 3 years old, actually. Three years already old. It's only 1,200. Right now, it's over 70,000 customers right now.
5,000 people in Fort Lauderdale.
Right now, we got a convention of over 5,000 people.
When he leaves here, he goes down there as one of the leaders in the company. One of the you're the Steven now. I mean to other people.
I'm like the Calvin.
The Calvin, yeah. He's like Calvin Klein.
There you go.
And so now me and you are going to do something in Mexico. You want to talk about that?
Oh,
Mexico City,
huge.
Man. Okay, I'm coming down to Matador. El Gran Cabron.
El Gran Cabron is coming to Mexico. El Padrino. So
what's the El Padrino?
Like the Godfather.
Okay. I like that, man.
So basically, it's amazing news. November 11th, we're going to have our convention in November 10 and 11. He's going to be one of our keynote speakers, which we're very excited about that. He did something similar. Grant did something similar in London. It was amazing.
London, we were walking. What street was that? That's one of the. Across the street from the big
Mandarin Oriental or.
Yeah, but. No. What's the shopping joint that we were at?
Oh.
Harrods.
Harrods. I'm walking across the street from Harrods. I'm walking into a Starbucks. I run into the good, most best-looking Latinos in all of Europe.
Tallest Mexican.
And he look. He doesn't even budge when I say that. He's like, it's true. It is true. It is true. I am a beautiful man. And so we run into him. I'm like, dude, what are you doing here? He's like, and I was busy. I was doing like 5 or 6 different interviews. And he's like, I'm doing a presentation later. I said, I'll come do it. Let me come do it with you, right? Yep. And so then we plan to do this.
Yes, and we've talked about it, and it's done. It's a real deal, and we're excited to have you in Mexico. And so he's going to be keynote speaker, but then we had a special event with Grant. He's going to be the main person in that event. That's going to be Monday, November 12th, from 10 a.m. to like 2 p.m. Right?
Yeah.
And we're going to do a sales training. And we're going to have over 2,000 people probably that Monday morning. Okay.
Yeah. How to build your business. So I'm going to go and do a keynote with them. They have a 2-day conference. And I said, hey, why don't we add Monday so we don't distract from the conference and we can just focus on this one thing? Mm-hmm. We can do some Q&A while we're there so we can really get people's. Awesome. Probably have a translator, right?
Yeah, we'll have a translator for you. Don't worry. Yeah.
But I need a translator in America. Because people can't even understand my English.
Well,
sometimes I say some bizarre things.
I know.
I think different. And by the way, this guy thinks different. He thinks different. I think you guys are hearing stuff. You hear, oh, network marketing. You're like, oh, what does that mean? You don't know what it means. So you start filling in the spaces. You say Forex or crypto. You guys, everybody needs a translator.
Oh.
So don't laugh at me because I need one when I go to Mexico City. Everybody needs a translator. The question is, do you get translated? Everybody needs a mentor. Everybody needs an example. And everybody needs inspiration. The thing that I'm most excited about coming to Mexico is like, how many people are going to be in that room?
Sunday's going to be 5,000.
So Monday, I'm going to be with 5,000 people that want success. That's good for me, man. Show me a church. Show me any place people gather and want to do better. To me, that's the biggest benefit of network marketing.
It is. It is.
Then it's the product and the opportunity.
Of course.
Or the education in your case. Because really, education is what you're doing.
Yeah, we're doing education, basically. I'm just excited. What me personally, since we joined this opportunity, besides only iMarkets Live, my mind has expanded to diversifying like crazy.
Yeah.
Like going to your events, going to Tony Robbins, going to all those people, having mentors. I always say this, follow and do exactly what your heroes do until your heroes become your partners. And that's always my mindset. We're partners too now. And now we're partners, look at that.
That's cool, too cool. So listen to what he's saying, guys. Okay, he's sitting in a chair, he's a humble dude, you know, he's telling you where he came from. It's been a pretty short trip, really. Yeah. It didn't feel sharp when you were going through it.
It did not feel sharp at all. But right now, we're just excited for the adventure, and we're more excited and passionate about what's about to come. Honestly, like we're very passionate about, like, we're already planning how's it going to be in the next 10 years. So it's just amazing.
Do you think it's possible for other people to make $100,000 a month?
Oh, definitely. Like, after you've done it, like, anybody can do it. I'm not special compared to anybody. I always say, like, one head, 2 feet, two arms, I have the same possibility. You guys can do it also.
Yeah. So you see, everybody's going to look at you and say, dude, he's so put together. He looks good. He's an awesome dude.
You should have seen me 10 years ago. Uh-huh. I was a mess. I was a real mess.
Have you gotten farther than you thought you would?
Back 10 years ago? Yes.
Yeah. I know I've gotten further than I just don't quit, man.
You guys
just don't quit. Every person is sat in this chair, like where Yvonne's sitting right now. Just say, man, just don't quit no matter how bad it gets. Keep trying, keep working at it. Keep being the fool that won't quit.
Yeah. People want those successes. No, I always tell people, I want to go to, they always say to heaven, right? Nobody wants to die.
Nobody wants to die, man. Nobody wants to die. Me. Everybody wants to be the boss. Nobody wants to write the check.
That's so
okay.
True.
Yvonne Tapia. Tapia.
You're good.
At the top, baby. At the top.
You're good.
Pia.
Only tell me whatever he wants.
How do people get a seat? How do people get a seat at the in Mexico City? By the way, all my friends in Ecuador, in Costa Rica, in Brazil, you guys are all in South America, man. Grab you a seat and go up to Mexico City.
English and Spanish needs to be.
I don't need to be part of the company to come to.
You don't need to be part of my company. That's why it's a separate event. That's why we have in Monday separate event. It's a separate event with Gran Cardone.
Yeah.
Reality is my company or iMarkets Live is not bringing Gran Cardone. It's a partnership that we created to bring Gran Cardone with him, of course. Throughout everything that we've done, it's actually Yvonne Tapia and my wife presenting Gran Cardone.
Yeah, and one of the reasons we moved to Miami was because this is the gateway to South America.
It is.
That's what I used to think until I met Yvonne, and I'm like, he is the gateway, okay? And Mexico City is going to be my first role down there with the most passionate people on the planet, which are in South America, undereducated. Financially illiteracy is like runs rampant down there, okay? There is not a middle class for you guys to tap into. Like, you have been suppressed for years. It's time that you get the right information from the right people that are winning, find a great opportunity. I'll be there, he'll be there, he's a good dude, okay? Thank you for coming in today, man.
No, thank you for having me.
You're awesome, you're awesome. Every time I'm around you, bro, every time I'm around you, I feel stronger.
Me too.
It freaking, man, just get around strong people. Get around people that are inspirational. It's going to rub off.
I just want to get closer to them. That's all I want. Okay. Get closer to people you want to be like. Let's go.
Okay. Hey, I look forward to the day you sit in that chair as a power player and tell your story to my audience. Okay. My friends, my family. God bless you guys. Be great. Find your power.
You're right. You're right. You're right. You're right. People love to be right. Mm-hmm. 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 How many of you want to sell more products? How do you grow a business? Top line, move the top line, sell businesses.
I don't want to waste more than 5 minutes on $3,000.
The question is, what if I want to monetize my content ideas?
It's going to be a great product and a great service. You don't need to go prove it.
Marketing and promotion is the lifeblood of your business. Have you tried Facebook, Instagram, LinkedIn, YouTube, and have no clue why you're not getting leads, followers, or any traction? Have you worked with other agencies and then nothing happened? 10X Productions, Grant Cardone's digital advertising agency, is now available for you to get on track with social media lead generation, full-scale training, and production. We'll get you the leads and give you the training to understand your social media and how to build a brand better. Just go to CardoneAdvertising.com. That's CardoneAdvertising.com to get your free marketing assessment, and we will get you on the road to the right marketing and all of your business needs. Visit Cardone Advertising right now.
Automatons, or artificial beings capable of independent thought, have been a fixture of science fiction, literature, and motion pictures throughout time.
Today, the convergence of technology and imagination has reached new heights, which are reflected in the advancements that we see in every area of our lives. Over the last couple of years, AI machines have made their way into our homes, the battlefield, our workplace, and even into our hands in the form of smartphones with voice recognition. Digital assistants for the home represent an opportunity if you know how to take advantage of them. That is where Niko's Computer Engineering comes in. Tim Clark brings you the latest news about the most up-to-date strategies to position yourself in the digital landscape, finding a path to productive business applications and how to automate them with artificial intelligence are just a few of the topics we cover in our weekly segments.
Niko's Computer Engineering is here to find a unique solution for you.
The reality is that if you haven't walked in those boots, you really don't know what it's all about. You don't know what it's like to be homeless. You don't know what it's like to be alone. One day, you're in an organization where your brother is covering your back, and the next day, you have no idea what you're going to do next. You don't have a plan for your life. Your family doesn't understand you. Friends, relatives, nobody. Well, there are answers. We have a plan and a system to get you where you want to go in life. We have a group of people that care about your situation to help you in every area of your life and to make you the best person you were designed to be. To learn more, go to facebook.com/lyman.dev.grp.
Growing your future, protecting your past. J.D. Frost & Company, PLLC, is a public accounting firm. Offers a variety of assurance and tax services to businesses and individuals in the Chattanooga and surrounding areas. We focus on construction and manufacturing industries. Our primary objective is client satisfaction through excellent customer service. Work with the best. We are accredited by the BBB. This is J.D. Frost & Company for a full suite of tax assurance and management accounting services. Visit us right now at frostcpas.com.
Marco Santarelli of Narada Real Estate is the foremost expert in getting your money to work for you. At Narada, most people do not have the time to invest or do the work it takes to grow their wealth. Marco and his team will handle it. Working in 16 markets nationwide, Marco and his team will help set up a strategy to take you through step-by-step how to invest your money the right way and get you earning 8% returns from day one. If you need financing, we have it handled. The inspection for your property, if you need titles done, we have it handled. This is a one-stop shop to get you involved in the real estate game. Narada Real Estate and Marco Santarelli will ensure that you have what you need to start investing the right way. To learn more, visit NaradaRealEstate.com. That's NaradaRealEstate.com.
The more comfortable you get with yourself, the less scary it is for people to actually see you.
We all know as parents that there's nothing more powerful than a mother's love. And how can I be that extraordinary parent for my kids?
And how kind we are to each other.
The more that you love you, the less you care if others love you.
The idea is to really just choose to be with yourself.
The challenges and the struggles and the frustrations and the self-doubt and insecurities can often keep us from living. We can master our lives from the inside out.
Chris Root of Hustle Wholesaling.
Chris is in the real estate space, but he's figured out a little niche of it, flipping deals, what he calls hotailing and wholesaling.
I want to show you how to get into real estate without making all the mistakes I have.
He actually doesn't own the real estate. What he does is he buys a contract. You don't actually buy the contract, you control the contract.
Correct.
Visit chrisroot.com to book a call right now.
This will be our third fund. It's a $40 million fund. So we're giving people a chance now to say, hey, I want to be involved in big, big, giant real estate deals that pay money. These are deals that are doing anywhere from 160 to 200% returns. You put $1 million into a deal and you're coming out with $2 to $3 million, but it's going to take 10 years. This is not get rich quick, okay? If you're taking notes, write this down. Don't do the get rich quick, man. Go for the get rich for sure. I don't need to get rich quick. I want to get rich for sure. So I'm going to go from 4,000 units. How many do you think I should go to? I'm going to go to 40,000 units. This is what I'm going to do, and this is why I'm going to do this. I'm going to go to 40,000 units, and I'm going to get the whole world involved in it. You're either going to invest with me, or you're going to actually help me raise these funds. Okay, so when you see me on social media talking about other stuff, anything that you see me talking about, what I'm doing is building an audience so I can allow people to get in a vehicle to where everybody gets rich. Let me tell you something, if you want to make happy customers for life, make them money.